Murder charges filed against 9 policemen in the killing of Calpayog City Mayor Ronaldo Aquino. The local official and 3 of his men were killed last year. Prosecutors determined they were killed in an ambush, not in a shootout, as claimed by the accused. The police officer had admitted to conspiring with the slain mayor's political rivals. The slain mayor's son says political violence still persists in the province.
Involved po na police ay patuloy pong pupunta dito sa lugar namin. Ang nakaraang linggo lang po, meron pong tatlong barangay officials po ang pinatay. Mga dating taga-suporta ng aking ama nang siya pa po ay nabubuhay pa.
Oh.
Actually, pilit po silang kinuha sa kanilang pamamahay at kinalagkan po papunta sa labas at wow. Doon pinagbaparil po. Humihingi po kami ng tulong sa gobyerno na sana po matutukan ng bayan namin at saka ang buong probinsya ng Samar.
Proposal of a Davao mayor and vice presidential candidate Sara Duterte Carpio to mandate military service for all Filipinos turning 18 years old, that's been getting some mixed reactions. Defense Chief Delfin Lorenzana believes the proposal has merits, but he says implementing this comes with a number of huge challenges. Among them, funding. Lorenzana notes implementing the Reserve Officers Training Corps Program, or ROTC, in private and public schools is a better alternative. The armed forces, meanwhile, sees Duterte Carpio's plan to be a big boost in nation building. Akbayan Party List begs to differ. It describes the proposal as absurd and irrelevant, saying government's focus should still be on COVID response. Sara Duterte Carpio and fellow vice presidential candidate Waldon Bello trade barbs over the proposed mandatory military service. Bello slammed Duterte's idea, calling her a dictator in waiting. The Davao mayor hit back by calling Bello an ungrateful citizen. She said she hopes the youth do not follow his example. And this was Bello's reply.
If they only bothered to do their research, alam naman nila that I have done more for protecting the sovereignty of the Philippines than most of these generals or even her father. She owes me an apology, but I'm not going to press it.
Meanwhile, a political and governance expert also expressed reservations on Duterte's proposal.
Where will we get the money for this? This proposal, while initially may sound good, upon further testing of and reflection, it may not be a good idea after all. The only reason why I initially thought it was a good idea is because we have an imminent national security threat, which is China.
Jonas Abadilla, a student leader at the University of the Philippines, Diliman, slams Sara Duterte's proposal to mandate military service. Abadilla says the program is prone to physical and verbal abuse given its history. He also says there are other pressing concerns that need to be addressed, such as education and the health crisis.
We can have advanced civic or peace building education. So promote more about culture, the Philippines, to instill more nationalism in our country, not mandatory ROTC or militarism. Promote the values and of peace and respect for human rights is very essential right now amidst the pandemic.
Abadilla also called on the education sector to oppose that proposal.